Welcome, friends. Hope you guys are doing well, and thank you for joining us here today. Our team 2020 is ready with a new webinar session, a series of webinars on topic advances in aerospace materials. And this event is organized by Professor A. Vivekananda from Excel Engineering College. He is also an Air Veteran of Indian Air Force and current faculty of Excel Engineering College, Department of Aeronautical Engineering. I am the CEO of Team 2020, Moaz Hussain, and we are here with our resource person, Professor Souvik Brahma Hota, who is a research associate and lecturer in Techno India University, Kolkata, West Bengal. He was also attached with West Bengal University of Technology under Government of West Bengal. Briefing his achievement, and he is a gold medalist in Masters and a university rank holder in the Bachelor's during his Bachelor's. He was also awarded with Best Research Paper Award from the Defense Metallurgical Research Lab, DRDO, and Best Research Proposal Award from IIT Kharagpur. He has published many international papers in international conferences and reputed journals. So today we are going to discuss about the first topic of this session, of this series, Micro Manufacturing in Aerospace Industries. So Mr. Professor Souvik Brahma Hota, sir, you can start.
Today, we are going to learn about micro manufacturing process. So, as Mr. Moaz Hussain already introduced myself, so without further delaying, I just want to give my gratitude to Professor A. Vivekananda sir, because he is that teacher who has actually recognized my potential and actually motivate me from my B times, my bachelor times. So from that time, I just look forward to the research arena, and then I pursued all these masters, and then I joined this research associate and lecturer in Techno India University. So before I start, I want to just give some view about what is micro manufacturing process. So there is often some confusion as to what micro manufacturing means. This is because the term has two definitions. The micro manufacturing can refer to manufacturing in a small number of sizes, and also the quantity can be small. But here we will only emphasize the size, because we know as of aerospace, there is always a fight for space. So we have to integrate a lot more things, a lot more components within a small space. So for that reason, we have to concentrate on how to manufacture all these big components at a micro, or let me say a nano level. So if it is more precise, then 10 to the power minus 6 to 10 to the power minus 9, this kind of range. So micro manufacturing is a process to produce smaller size with higher accuracy. These types of method create various electronic and mechanical devices, which have been widely expected in aerospace, in aircrafts, this kind of industries, and also in automobile industries. So in the early days of computer and electronics, critical component including switches, then electric contents, resistors, conductors, transistors, semiconductors could all be manufactured through more traditional process. When I say traditional, means conventional, like we know the mechanical process, and like blade machining, this turning, fashing, then also drilling operation, milling, grinding, so this kind of processes. But today we can now carry more raw processing and computational power to our smartphone. So this entire paradigm shift happens when NASA launches its space program, US space program, around 1960s. So the process resembles the creation of a full circuit, but a much smaller scale, using lasers engineering and also using ultrasonic technique and also other things. We are manufacturing all these large scale component at a very precise small at a nano level. So the smallest micro machine can only be few hundred micron. We know in aerospace the development are actually happening. Aerospace engineers can use micro machine parts for variety of purpose, like making sensors, micro actuators, and engine navigation system. We know that is the navigational instruments and this complicated head-up display. We all know about it. So therefore, we can say micro is the way to the modern world. From consumer product to be medical and aerospace industries, these things are getting more popular. And thus, the industry 4.0's goal has been changed. How to produce this micro thing and how to get the macro level advantage from these micro things. So, I should start with my presentation today. So, today I am going to deliver about the mechanical micro machining and also chemical micro machining technique. So I just want to play that presentation. So today's topic of our webinar is the micro manufacturing in aerospace industries. So in this topic we'll be going to discuss about the introduction, which I have told, and then the need of this MMP, that is the micro manufacturing process, and the classification. There are very various kind of classification available. We'll discuss about that thing, and then how this thing get evaluated, and then the basic working principle of some MMPs, and then what is micro finishing process. As we all know, after the machining we have to go for the finishing. So that too will be in micro level. So we have to consider this micro finishing process, and then the future of this micro manufacturing. What is the possibility? What are the research areas of this micro manufacturing process? So the process resembles the creation of full size thing into a very nano level, into a very micro or nano level. So nowadays, this technique basically widely expected in the production or manufacturing area. Today's demand, the client's demand for the industries are varied. So they are like extraordinary property of material they want. They want complex 3D components. They want miniaturization. They want nano level surface finish of complex geometry. So all these things, if we have to meet as an industry, then we should not do all these things with the help of our conventional machining process. So for that, we have to shift towards advanced manufacturing techniques, and especially this micro manufacturing technique. So industries like aerospace, automobile, missile, nuclear reactors, there are various kind of engineering materials that have been used. And today we are using some developed engineered products that are having high ultimate tensile strength, higher hardness value, high temperature resistance. Then this thing, if they are having higher hardness value, they are very much difficult to machine by the conventional machining method. So that is the problem, how to machine those modern days engineering materials. So for that, we have to think about advanced manufacturing process and this micro machining techniques, basically where the workpiece hardness does not matter in this kind of machining. So this is a classification of method of micro fabrication. When I say fabrication, that means the manufacturing process. So that has been classified into three categories. That is material deposition, then material removal, and that material forming. So material forming actually in micro manufacturing, it is known as micro forming. That can be defined as the process of manufacturing a part, a feature by plastic deformation, whose at least one orthogonal view can be enclosed in a square of 1 mm size. So I am saying in a square of 1 mm size, that means how much small it is. So micro forming is also defined as production of part of structure with least two dimension in the sub-millimeter range. The micro size component are used in micro system. You know, systems are very popular in aerospace industries. They are known as MEMS. These are micro electromechanical systems. Then typical example of such components can be the pins of integrated circuits, fasteners, the micro screws, the micro rivets, the lead frame, and the sockets, and various other things that has been widely accepted in aerospace industry. Now, if we talk about the material deposition, that is nothing but the additive manufacturing technique. The same thing we're gonna talk in our future lectures. So this additive manufacturing technique is nothing but this material deposition, where the 3D printing, selective laser sintering, and then stereolithography, tube deposition modeling are there. And also chemical vapor deposition, physical vapor deposition, electro-discharge deposition, this kind of deposition techniques are there. But today, our concentration will be material removal process, and not to the traditional material removal process, but to this advanced material removal process. So why do we need this manufacturing, this micro-manufacturing process? So as I have already discussed, I think all you are aware of this, the need of this micro-manufacturing process, because when we are doing manufacturing for a good engineering material, which are having excellent hardness, excellent tensile strength, and all these things, that time they are not that much easy to machine in a micro level. So for that reason, we are going for this micro manufacturing process. So in aerospace industry, why we need miniaturization? Why we need all the things in a very small scale? Because it has some impact, it has some advantages. When we are doing this manufacturing in very micro level, in a miniaturization level, then there is utilization of minimized energy. So energy that has been used in this kind of production is not that much. And also the material that has been used, that is also too small. Then we can reduce this power budget. We can also minimize the cost. And at the same time, we can get a good performance, a faster device. We can increase the efficiency and accuracy, and also sensitivity of our materials, of our system. So for that reason, to integrate all these big things in a small scale, we need this miniaturization. So now we have to think about what are the micro products and why they are in use in our aerospace industry. So as this miniaturization takes place for today's world, especially in micro and nano level, these things are not comfortable with the ceramic material. Though I will discuss that ceramic material can also be processed with the help of this micro manufacturing technique. A dedicated technique is there for that, but we will be only considering the non-ceramic materials for this micro production. Only we will be considering some plastic products or some metal products. As we know, when we are manufacturing a turbine blade or a gas turbine engine, that time we know various channels, cooling channels are there in case of this gas turbine engine. So have you ever thought how this channel has been made? That has not been made with the help of this conventional technique. For that, we have to go for this advanced technique. So this microfabrication deals with the manufacturing in micro and nano level. And also, we can use microparts through molding, that is known as micro molding technique or micro casting technique. Nowadays, micro casting technique, namely permanent mold and investing casting, are being used in manufacturing industry. So attempts also been made, and various mathematical modeling has also been developed to do this process in microscopic level. So micro casting is a manufacturing process for producing small structure in the micrometer, and also to produce some small fasteners that has been used in aerospace industry for a specific area. So when we talk about this material removal process, we have to think there is two kind of process that is already existed in our industry. First, we have to go for the machining, and we have to go for the finishing. Because if we just leave the part after machining process, that is not sufficient, because there are some deformities, there are some burring means excess material, some chip. So that has to be removed as soon as we have completed our machining process. So for that, this material removal process is classified into two categories. That is, first one is micro or nano machining, then micro or nano finishing. The two things are there in case of our traditional machining technique also, but in advance also we are going for this process. So when we talk about this micro finishing, we know in our traditional way that is grinding, surface finishing, lapping, honing. After milling process, we are applying honing. So in advanced case, what we use? We use AFM. This AFM is nothing but abrasive flow machining. And then CMF, that is chemo mechanical finishing. We'll discuss about it today. So this is the broad way of classification of this micro machining technique. So in the most left corner, we have traditional machine, that is micro turning, micro milling, micro drilling, and micro grinding. But today we only consider the advanced part, which has been mostly used in our aerospace industry, in our aviation industry. So that is the mechanical advanced micro machining, then thermal advanced micro machining, and then chemical advanced micro machining. But for today's lecture, we will only consider the mechanical micro machinings and then chemical micro machining, as this topic is a wide topic to be discussed. And you, if you know, this has been introduced as a course in IIT Guwahati, IIT Kanpur, even in our university also. So it's a 6-month course. So we cannot discuss all the things in this lecture. But I can give some ideas of some popular machining technique to this webinar. So in the last, we can there is a possibility of making some hybrid machining. So when combining this traditional advanced machining, we can see in the below there is a hybrid term. So that is nothing but hybrid machining. When we are combining the trend, we can make some hybrid machining. So that is the part of research. If anybody interested in this kind of research can do this research, and this kind of research is going on in aerospace industry. So based on the properties of working material means that material we are using for aerospace industry. So we are actually choosing the way how do we machine that product. So for electrically conducting material, we are using ECM, that is electrochemical machine. Then we are using EDM, electro discharge machine. Then EBM, electro beam machining. And for non electrically conduct or electrically conduct material, we can use our usual mechanical machining, that is AJM, abrasive jet machining, UFM, ultrasonic machining, LBM, laser beam machining, etc. And for thermal conductivity and reflective material, we can use LBM, that is laser beam, machining. So this micro machining or micro manufacturing have some specific area of application in our aerospace industry. As of now, I have been discussed with this how this thing is get popularized in aviation industry, but I have not given any example of specific case where we can use this thing appropriately. So let us discuss this thing now. So micro machining, as I have already told, this thing is nothing but the micro, that means micro or nano level we are machining this product. So these things are very popular in aerospace industries in case of some exchange heat exchanger tube. So you see laser cut stent like pattern. So in miniaturization, that is a stainless steel product which are having the outer diameter of 1.25 mm. So you can measure how much small it is. And this result drill dia, that is around 15 micrometer. So this kind of formation, this kind of processing is very much needed. We are when we are doing the cooling channel in case of our various engine components, and also for getting that pitot static tube to do that drilling, to do that channeling, micro channeling, we are using this kind of laser drill hole. But there are some problems when we are thinking about any new unconventional machining technique. As they are having numerous amount of advantages, they do have some problems with this kind of machine, like mechanical deformation. As it is already there in case of our conventional machining technique. When we are doing machining, we know the machining is nothing but calculation of all the various cutting force and also the shearing action. So due to that thing, when the deformation happen, only metal has been cutted. So mechanical deformation can be experienced in case of our working piece also, that is our work piece also. So that thing could be taken into account. In micro machining also, this mechanical deformation takes place, and this thermal deformation, as there has been lot of rubbing, lots of shearing action through this machine tools and then workpiece between these two things. So thermal deformation must be there, and the surface integrity. If we talk about surface integrity, we are doing a machining process with the help of any tool, then there is a chance of the material of that tool getting to that surface of that workpiece. It can happen. So this is generally happening in case of our normal machining process. In our micro machining process also, as it is done in micro level, there is a great chance of mixing this tool material into the surface area of the workpiece. And then we have to maintain a gap, a specific gap. In case of abrasive jet machining, we are defining this gap as a standoff distance. So that standoff distance should be made between the tool and the workpiece. If you are not maintaining that thing, the whole machining process will be destroyed. The whole catastrophic failure will occur. So we have to think about this thing. We have to minimize this thing. So these are the areas where we can put our effort into research. These are the research gaps. And then coordinate shift in tool handling. Coordinate shift means, in case of CNC, we know we can easily program every coordinate, we can easily program every machining technique. So there is a coordinate shift when we want to shift from face turning to taper turning, then there is a shift. There is a change of tool. So for that reason, at that time, some kind of failure can happen in case of our micro machining. So that kind of thing we have to consider. We have to minimize this thing. So these are the problems which we have encountered when we are doing this micro machining technique in our labs. So engineering materials, as all of you know, can be classified in broadly three categories. So metals and alloys, and plastics and composites, and ceramics products. So metals and alloys, there is no problem because some techniques, some CNC techniques are there for them. and some advanced techniques are there for them. But for micro manufacturing, metals and alloy, that has been possible. So that is not a problem for us. But plastic and composite and ceramic, these things have to be micro manufactured with the help of this advanced machining process. Because we know when we are doing some project with some composites, when we are doing some project with this composite and plastic, then there is a chance, there is a chance to deform when we are cutting some composite parts. So we usually face a lot of challenge when we are machining with this composite. Composite cannot be machined with the help of our traditional tool. Because if we are giving some amount of amount of pressure to that composite, there is a chance of delamination. You know, delamination is just the two part of a composite, the two layer of a composite actually detach from each other. So that is a delamination that happens. And also some layers of composite, some fibers of composite can be deformed. So this type of thing can be easily machined with the help of this kind of micro machining technique. So this advanced micro machining technique is applied in some portion, like I have already told about this turbine blade. All you know who are the student of this aeronautical engineering, they well known about this turbine blade, that gas turbine blade. So we know these gas turbine blades are experiencing enormous amount of temperature, around 1700 2800 and more on. This kind of temperature they are experiencing. So for them, it is very essential for a cooling channel. Numerous cooling channels should be there in a turbine. Otherwise, it will get deformed when it experiences a lot of heat at a longer period of time. It will have this creep failure also. So we have seen this kind of holes. You can see these holes there. This is a channels and holes from where you can just pass your cooling fluid. So this thing can be done with the help of electrochemical machining. This is another micro machining technique. And also, if we take an example of this thing, this is a part of helicopter turbine. So in case of helicopter turbine also, we are having numerous number of holes to pass the flow of that relative air. So for that, we need some micro holes to be formed, because we know the micro holes having significance as we reduce the area of the hole, there is a Venturi effect that is proposed by Bernoulli. Because when we are reducing the area, that time the cooling effect will be enhanced, because the pressure there basically reduces and the velocity increases in case of these small holes. So thereby the temperature also reduces. So see how these holes are there, 0.09 mm diameter hole. And the hole density, look at the hole density, 4000 per centimeter square. So in a small area, centimeter square is a very small area. Within that area, we have to do 4000 holes. So this is not possible with the help of our traditional machining technique. So these things are mainly done with this E-beam process. It is also an advanced micro manufacturing technique, electron beam machining. We will discuss about that process, how it has been done. And this is the current trend in our aeronautics and aerospace engineering. So working principle of some micro manufacturing technique can be discussed here. So we know advanced micro manufacturing techniques like abrasive jet micro manufacturing, abrasive water jets, and then water jet machining, and also ultrasonic machining, micro machining. So first we have to understand what is abrasive jet machining. So abrasive jet machining is a micro machining technique. We know in advanced manufacturing or unconventional machining technique, there is an abrasive jet machining technique that has been existed only. But when we are talking about this micro machining, that means the same AGM technique has been applied in a micro or nano level. So in abrasive jet micro machining, abrasive particles have been made to impinge on the work material at a high velocity, and the jet of abrasive particle is carried by a clear gas. So this is the technique where we are just jetting some amount of abrasive particle with the help of a carrier gas into a work material. So see, here is an example, good example. A man is hitting on a wall with the help of a ball, that yellow color ball. First, he is just applying a one amount of force, and the ball have a indentation, or that ball have a crater, that is the whole size of T1 in case of this first case. And for the second case, he is applying some force, that is F2, and he is getting the crater of D2 size. So if the condition such that F2 is greater than F1, there must be the increment of crater, that means G2 must be greater than T1. So that is the principle behind this abrasive machining technique, abrasive jet machining technique, or in case of water jet machining technique, and also abrasive water jet machining technique. And the size of this D1, D2, these are all function of kinetic energy of ball is hitting on the wall. So if the kinetic energy increases, that means it have a good impact. It will create a greater crater. So this abrasive jet machining, micro machining, is done with a high velocity, so that we get high amount of kinetic energy. As you know, kinetic energy is nothing but half mv square. So if we increase the velocity, that means we can increase the kinetic energy. That means we can do the machining process in a very rapid way. So these are all the techniques. We can see WJM, that is the water jet machining. Then AWJM, that is abrasive water jet machining. And then AJM, that is abrasive jet machining. So why I have just given all these three things in a single slide, as these are the principle behind these three things are same, but the material which are used for material machining are different. For first case, we are using water at a high velocity. Then we are using water and sand for abrasive water jet machining. And for AJM, we are using air, carrier gas, and that abrasive particle, and we are machining the process. So this abrasive jet micro machining, in that case, what happens, the jet of abrasive particle that has been carried by the carrier gas at a high velocity actually strike onto the substrate, and it will come from a nozzle. You can see that nozzle, the tapper, that nozzle, and the nozzle diameter is so small, it will be around 0.8 mm, and there is a gap. You can see in the three cases there is a gap, that is known as the tool and the workpiece distance gap. So that is known as the standoff distance. So in general case, we will be maintaining 0.5 to 15 mm of this standoff distance. So it has numerous applications. Abrasive jet micro machining, or abrasive water jet micro machining, or water jet micro machining is highly used in aerospace electronic industries. In aerospace industries, for such as titanium bodies for military aircraft. The titanium is very difficult to machine, but we can do the machining with the help of this abrasive jet micro machining. And also, we can use the interior cabin part that has been very easily manufactured by this abrasive water jet cutting. So the principle which I have already discussed, it depends upon the kinetic energy of every fine abrasive particle. Because if the kinetic energy increases, means that material removal process also increases. And if we talk about how the material has been removed, in case of ductile workpiece, the shear deformation takes place, and in case of brittle workpiece, the brittle factor takes place at the place of impact, where basically the abrasive get into the striking into the surface of that work material. So these are the application we know. The holes up to 66 micro millimeter. That is a deep hole. Without applying any kind of other drilling operation, we can do that hole with the help of this technique. Micro bars are clearly visible in this machining process. So we know when we are doing some machining, there have been something like, you know, excess material parts. So that kind of material part, that micro bar, easily visible in this process. So what is the advantage? If we easily see this kind of micro bars, we can easily remove that kind of micro bar with our finishing process. And this process is very useful to produce micro cavity. Some cases we need some micro cavity, some micro ducts. Now let us talk about this laser beam machining, LBM. So this laser beam machining is nothing but a thermal material removal process. Actually, it is utilizing high amount of energy. It is a coherent light beam source to melt and vaporize the particles on the surface of the metallic or in case of non-metallic one. So laser can be used to cut, to drill, to weld, and also to mark the object. So LBM particularly suitable for accurate placed holes. When we are doing some holding operation, hole operation, we are making some holes on to some pieces, but we need it very accurate, we need it very precise. That time we are using this laser beam machining. We know in case of that helicopter, that turbine part, when we are doing that 4000 holes in a centimeter square area, that time we are using this laser beam machining because it has been so much precious and it has is so much accurate, so we can use this thing. But the main thing is that it has low machining efficiency. Machining efficiency means, machining efficiency is nothing but the ratio of output and input. So output means whatever the parts we are machining and the amount of energy we are inputting. So the ratio is lesser than one, that means more amount of energy is needed in this laser beam machining. So that is the one disadvantage of this laser beam machining process. So in this laser beam machining process, we are using normally CO2 laser and NDYAG, that is neodymium doped yttrium aluminium garnet laser. So this NDYAG laser are having up to 50 kilowatt of power. Okay. And the CO2 laser are having up to 25 kilowatt of power. Then, if you are talking about this ultrasonic machining, just in the beginning, I have told the non-metals or the ceramics that has to be machined with the help of this advanced micro machining technique. So for that, this is the dedicated section. So how to do the machining of these composites, how to do machining of the ceramic part, the plastic part, because they are too much brittle, they easily break. So without the contact of the tool onto the workpiece, we are doing this machining technique. So this is the ultrasonic machining process. Here, it is also a mechanical removal with the help of ultrasonic sound. So what happens in this process? See, it is an ultrasonic transducer. So by this transducer, the ultrasonic sound has been generated. And this generation of this sound with the help of this transducer can be three types. That means this transducer can be three types. They are using piezoelectric effect, they are using either magnetostrictive effect, or they are using electrostrictive effect. So most of the cases we are using piezoelectric effect. And some arrangement of this system, we can see this blue color, this above, this blue color thing is nothing but the tool, ultrasonic machining tool, micro machining tool, and the ceramic part, that is our workpiece. And in between the tool and the workpiece, you can see clearly there is a gap. So there is no direct contact between the tool and the workpiece. So it eliminates the chance of breaking of this brittle material. So in between them, basically we are using abrasive slurries. Abrasive slurries are nothing but the abrasive particles and the liquid carriers. Sometimes we can use the water also. For mild steel and all these thing, metal parts, if we are using this USM, we should not use water, because we know water tends to coat the mild steel very easily. So for ceramic part, we can use the water as well as with the abrasive thing also. And this abrasive particle in top our USM process, basically aluminium oxide, Al2O3, alumina, silicon oxide, glass beads, corundum, these are all the abrasive things. And the ultrasonic wave have a frequency of 15 to 30 kilohertz. So a very high frequency wave is being generated over here. And the gap, see the tool and the workpiece gap, which is in case of our abrasive jet machining is around 50 micrometer. But in case of our ultrasonic micro machining, we are providing 25 to 40 micrometer of gap. And we can see from the transducer, when the wave is being generated, it is transformed to the transformer and then tool holder. And you can see the transformer section, that is nothing but a tapered section. Some area reduction is there. And this is known as exponential horn. Exponential horn. That horn can be exponential, that horn can be stepped, that horn can be other shapes. So this exponential horn is basically used to increase the amplitude and at the same time the intensity of this ultrasonic wave, so that the intensity of this wave is get amplified and it will be transferred to the tool, so that when the tool gets vibrated with this ultrasonic wave, it will also vibrate that abrasive and liquid carrier in between the tool and the workpiece. When the each abrasive and liquid carrier between the tool and the workpiece gets a good vibration, then it will just rub over the ceramic part. Due to that, the metal will be removed from the ceramic part. So, what is the advantage of this USM? USM is a non-thermal process, you know, there is a no chance of heat, that much heat generation. It is a non-chemical process, no chance of corrosion over air. And it is very much suitable for brittle materials, you know, brittle materials like ceramics. And also, machine part in USM process have better surface finish than other machine parts. And USM does not produce thermal, electrical, or chemical abnormalities in the surface of the workpiece. So then let us talk about the electrochemical micro machining process. When we are thinking of this kind of electrochemical micro machining process, it is not a mechanical micro machining process. The previous things which I have told, that is that abrasive jet machining, abrasive water jet machining, water jet micro machining, and ultrasonic machining, these are all mechanical processes. But this electrochemical micro machining process is purely a chemical micro machining process. So this is a reverse electroplating process. If we know about what is electroplating, we know that in negative terminal electroplating, we kept our substrate that has to be plated. And in positive, that is in anode, we kept that material whose coating has to be coated on the substrate. But here, we are doing that opposite. In electroplating or electrodeposition, we are depositing the material onto the workpiece. But here, we are subtracting the material or the metal from the workpiece. So this electrochemical micro machining is highly recommended for conductive material, not for non-conductive material. For conductive material only we can apply this kind of process. In this process, the particles travel from the anodic material, that is the work, towards the cathodic material, that is the machine tool. And the current of electrolytic fluid carries away the that is the depleted material before it has attached to the machine. So there is a chance, see, this tool is cathode, so it has a negative polarity, and this workpiece is anode, so it has a positive polarity. So from this anode, when we are applying in between them some electrolyte, there is a chance, not there is a chance, there must be some positive metals ion which will form from this workpiece, and it will be attracted towards our cathode, that is our tool. But this will not happen. The electrolyte in between them basically flashes all the metal ions that are come from the workpiece, that is the anode, and that will be taken to a different chamber. So by this way, we are doing the machining process with the help of electrochemistry. We are applying here the Faraday's law of electricity, and we are getting this thing. So this electrochemical micro machining is a very effective process to produce holes, cooling holes, cooling channels, micro channels over the turbine blade. And also doing some micro channeling if it is needed for passing some amount of working fluid in our hydraulic or in our pneumatic system. So the cavity produced is very much accurate over here. So there are some advantages of this electrochemical machining, micro machining. So the components are subject to either thermal or mechanical stress in case of our mechanical micro machining. But in case of our electrochemical micro machining, there is no chance of having any kind of thermal and mechanical stress. No tool wear happens during this electrochemical micro machining process. And the debarring part, debarring means in case of AJM, in case of USM, all the micro mechanical micro machining techniques, what about the burrs? Whatever excess material has been produced due to the machining, that can be deburred with the help of this electrochemical machining technique very easily with a very cheap way. So it is not that much costly. But if I talk about electron beam machining or laser beam machining, that has much more cost than this electrochemical micro machining technique. Now we have to consider some advanced nano finishing process, because when we are done with our machining process, we have to think about the finishing process. Because you know, in aerospace or aeronautical industry, we will never compromise the safety, we will never compromise of any kind of material quality. So for that reason, we have to go for the finishing process. Because some materials, you know, the turbine blades, if they are not that much finished, they are not have that smooth contour, there is a chance of formation of vortex, there is a chance of formation of vorticity over the airflow, over the turbine blade. So we know in every time we have to consider the aerodynamics of each individual part which has used in case of our aerospace product. So for that reason, we have to think about the contour, we have to think about the profile of each individual part. So if there is a no good surface finish, that kind of smoothness is not there, then how can we achieve that aerodynamicity? So for achieving that thing, we have to concentrate on nano finishing process. We will not compromise any kind of metal surface that cause any kind of localized drag, because if there is a localized drag, there is a chance of formation of a integral drag that can cause any kind of air blockage, any kind of stalling effect in case of any of our turbine, then it will hamper the efficiency of the engine. So you should consider a good nano level finishing process, advanced nano finishing process for each of our machined, micro machined parts. So here we are doing the finishing in a nano level. So we are using ion beam machining. Generally, we are using ion beam machining and then elastic emission machining. But in some case, we can use some abrasive flow machining and also chemo electrical machining and chemo mechanical machining. So this chemo mechanical polishing or chemo mechanical machining is needed where we use the chemical and mechanical aspect. So this chemo mechanical polishing we are doing in our lab. This is not that much costly because we are using some chemicals like some silicon powder we are using, and we mix it with water, and then what we are doing, we are applying it in between the tool, that polishing tool and the workpiece. So what happens, it's silicon wafer and the water, that thing chemically reacts with the upper surface of that workpiece, and it will basically soften the upper layer. So it will help to finish that metal surface very easily. But there are some limitations in this chemo mechanical polishing process. Like we always need some flat surface over here. We cannot machine a contoured surface or a wavy surface or a surface that are having micro hills and valleys. This kind of surface cannot be polished with the help of this CM process. But in general, we are using this kind of process onto turbine blades, onto the turbine casing, because it will give a good surface finish at a micro level. It will give a good that aerodynamicity over the materials. So, and it is not that much costly. So that is why it is widely accepted in aerospace industries, and we are using this kind of polishing technique for our final product. So now we have to think, what is the future of this micro machining, micro manufacturing? See, throughout this lecture, I have just concentrated how this micro manufacturing technique is very easily machined the hard machinable parts of this aerospace industry. The modern materials that are having higher hardness value, they are having some brittleness also, that can be machined very easily and precisely. Even it is good machinable, very easily machinable with the help of our conventional machining technique, that part also machined very precisely and very accurately in case of this micro manufacturing technique. So it is an ongoing research arena, and a lot of things has to be done, and we are doing some research on this thing. And as I have told earlier, there is a chance of proposing some hybrid micro manufacturing process, that means combination of advanced and unconventional, or in between combination of any kind of mechanical advanced and chemical advanced process. So this kind of combination can be done. So we have to consider that thing, and we have to reduce the cost of the tool, because you know, have you ever think about that, how, why a Rolex watch is that much costly? Because you know, the tiny parts of that watch is machined by this kind of micro manufacturing technique. They are using electron beam machining technique. They are using electro deposition machining technique, electro discharge machining technique. So this electro discharge machining technique itself, the tool used for this electro discharge machining technique, that is very costly, because to machine the tool itself, it is very costly process, because we have to precisely manufacture the tool for that machining. Because when we are machining at a nano, at a micro level, our tool should not be that much big.
our should our tool must be having a definite a good dimension, a micro level dimension. So that dimension, if it has been to be maintained, we have to follow and have to go to some advanced level of tool manufacturing technique. So that technique basically a cost process. So production of that tool itself is a costly process. So if we are doing some kind of research to produce that kind of tool at a very low cost, then this kind of micro manufacturing technique can be done with a least with a very least expenditure. And then in this way we can popularize this process not only in our aerospace industry but also in our automobile industries and also in of our normal textile industries. Then the efficiency and accuracy. See, when we are talking about this efficiency and accuracy in case of our aerospace industry or aeronautics, there has been no limit, because the more accurate and the more efficient product is always a search for an aerospace engineer. There is no limit of accuracy. So we always going for reaching the maximum desired level of accuracy and efficiency to get a better efficiency for our product, to get a better workability of our product. So for that, if we increase some further efficiency, accuracy, precision of our product, that can be carried out, that can be done with the help of this micro manufacturing technique. So that is a chance, there is a chance of some research in this kind of process. And then we have to think about how to reduce the power consumption. Though normal micro machining process, that means mechanical micro machining process, will not consume that amount of power. But in case of laser beam machining, in case of our ion beam machining process, this kind of process takes more power. And we know in our laser beam machining process, that is why the machining efficiency is less than one. So we have to think about how to reduce the power consumption or how to use some alternative energy of power like solar power and other power that can be used to run all this machine in our micro machining technique. So with this note, I can see as for micro machining and micro manufacturing products, there is still plenty of room to grow and techniques to perfect. Researchers are currently exploring the possibilities of hybrid manufacturing process, and also they are actually concentrating on how to eliminate, how to reduce the cost of the tool production, and also how to popularize this process by reducing the power consumption and enhancing the accuracy of our micro manufactured parts in case of our aerospace industry. So that is for today's lecture. I thanks all of you for having a patience hearing. And for today's crisis thing, whatever pandemic is going on, I request all of you to keep physical distance. Use proper mask and maintain hygiene. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for this informative session. I hope all our students have got very good knowledge about this micro manufacturing in our aerospace industry as well as all other industries wherever it is required. This is a very wide opportunity. There is a very wide opportunity for us to have research in this area, in this specific field. And me, on the behalf of our team 2020, wish to extend my thanks to all our listeners, all our audience, and also to Professor A. Vivekananda for organizing this wonderful event. And also I want to convey my thanks to our audience member. The next session, please be with us, keep in touch with us. We will have two more sessions with our Professor Souvik Verma Huda sir. And stay safe, stay connected, and keep learning. Thank you very much, Team 2020.